creating links. What we've been looking at so far is linking to web pages, but you can pretty much link to any kind of file that you can create. The thing you need to keep in mind is if you link to something like PowerPoint, the person viewing your page will need PowerPoint in order to see it. So I'm just going to kind of go through the different media you can link to. And this is not a comprehensive list because you can pretty much link to anything. And the syntax is the same as in linking to a web page that is at a different site. Okay, so we've got our anchor hypertext reference. We have to give it the address of the object we are linking to, and you need a closing anchor. So if you're linking to a different domain, so a different server that's on the internet, you're going to do an absolute link. So if you're linking to a news group, unless you have news groups on your site, this is going to be an absolute link where you're giving it the full address. And this is the link text that is displaying. And I'm just going to kind of middle click on these so you can see that these news groups do actually exist. Okay, so this is how we would link to those. And to link to files that aren't web pages, it's pretty much the same as linking to a web page. Now you'll notice that I'm not giving it the full address. What that means is this peanut butter and jelly file is located in the lesson 3 folder. It is in the same folder as this lecture. Okay, so I only have to give it the name of the file. And if I click on that, you'll see that it kind of downloaded it. And in order for me to view that, I do have to have PowerPoint. For this next one, this is a text file. Again, I'm just giving it the name of the file, indicating that it is in the Lesson 3 folder. Now, most people can view text files. Let me middle click that. Okay. Text files are like a cross-platform format. They're very plain, and most people should be able to see that without any special software at all. WordPress, this is basically a website. Okay, and I had to include the full URL here. That is another one people should not have any trouble seeing, you know, if they're connected to the internet. Pinterest is another website. So this would be how the link looks. And that would be the Pinterest site. And I happen to be linking to mine because I know that they're not going to be moved or go away. But you can link to anyone's. Okay? So in this case, it happens to be mine. But if you key in the full address, you can pretty much link anywhere. Here's a link to a graphic. And you'll notice that this graphic is in the media folder. So we're starting at lesson 3. We're telling it to open the media folder and display this image. Here is another link to an image. Now, this happens to be an image at WordPress. So this is a super long address. Let me click on this. Okay, and that is the image. Now, if I was looking at WordPress and I wanted to link to this, I would just click up here, press Control and the letter C to copy, and I would paste that address into VS Code because this is just a really, really long address to try to key correctly. And then here's another one. This is to Flickr. And again, I'm just going to my own sites because I know that they're not going to move. Okay, I've had this one forever. Okay, so that's just examples how you would key to other sites. Whether you use the full URL or not, depends on the location of the file you are linking to. So this is very similar to linking the web pages, okay? We've got a lot of different media here, but whether you include the full address or not depends on where the page is being stored. Okay? If it's in one of your directories, you don't need the full address. Email links would be another type of link. This is how you create it. So instead of starting with HTTP or HTTPS, we've got mail to, followed by your email address. And then this is the text that is displayed. Now, if I click on this, I do need to have a mail client configured. And that's what it's trying to tell me here. And I can select Google Chrome. However, you can see that it did not go into my mail. So if I had a client configured, it would work fine.